Hello. Thanks to organizers of the conference for inviting me to participate. It is really very interesting topics, inspiring ideas and presentations from international speakers. It is very important for us to continue learning and training and hear about best practices from all over the world. So, and it is very important also to learn and to exceed these. And I do hope that soon we will be able to learn others as well. So, we will be happy to share also our experience when we have such, and we would like to be in a leading role. But today we will look at grain production. I would say that the grain sector right now is a success story during those 20 years. From just 100 million tons of grain, we have reached 900 million tons of grain per year, and we are exporting more than 650 million so value. These products, 20 years ago, that was zero. We were not exporting at all. And now it is 650 million euros, so this is really fast developing sector, and it becomes more and more of value for the Latvian national economy. Farmers become more knowledgeable, stronger. And I think that everybody would agree that one of the main driving forces for this sector is the fact that cooperation had been very strong, really, in this sector. 20 years ago, it started with Vax and LATRAPS, and those two leading cooperatives right now really have their name, have their say, for farmers to be competitive in the whole Europe and on the European level with their grain be represented in very many markets in Near East and also in Africa. So some 20 years ago it was unimaginable that we could be there in those markets. So it was one step. We have finalized this. So when you we have already half of the globe, we have reached it. Our grain is represented. Latvian grain is famous for its high quality. We sell, we receive currency, and farmers receive profit, but always we also say one thing: to sell just grain, that is just to sell raw material for others to earn with added value on our grain. So they produce something with value added, and our farmers are just the initial stage for all this. So just in this production chain, we are the first link, and the largest benefit it would be for somebody else. And thus, we have developed a project, not developed, we have actually worked with this. We have tried to find what could we do, so how could we get the highest value added for our grain or something else what we are producing. So we have completed different processes, we have analyzed, we have been closer, further from these projects. But right now, we have a real project which we are continuing, and it will be on stage in some years. And it will be a very serious cornerstone for Latvian national economy, for agriculture, for our farmers. And so the goal of our project is to ensure the sustainability of our cooperative members and to increase income and to make this income or profit stable. As we heard in one of the previous presentations, there are huge risks, including COVID risk. We even do not know whether we will be able to transport grain, whether this country would be able to pay, and and also price fluctuations, and it can also be different stores three times in volume. And so farmer can be a winner 1 year and loser next year. So we have to see how to make all the situation stable. So to be safer, of course, there is different hedging, different financial instruments, but also to try to take that value added and to make it here locally. And so what we also have to take into account, and we have to work with these aspects. So what are future challenges, global challenges? And some of these are mentioned here. So some are the greenhouse effect, of course, which really is a problem, global heating, and agriculture is said to be one of the major sectors regarding this, and so you are to be guilty. So resources, of course, it is also environmental and climate issues, and also food challenges. So whether we have enough food globally. And if we see prospects that it is planned that in 30 years we have 10 billion of inhabitants on the globe, and are we able to supply food for all everybody? And so it says that no. And if we have climate changes as they are now, then it is possible that it will be a real challenge to provide food for all inhabitants of the globe. So, and we have to try to find some solution for these issues, and so we would like to offer the best way, the best possibility to solve all these challenges, and our farmers should benefit. So our farmers should be beneficiaries of this process. So they need real stability for their work. And some figures here. So according to calculations in the world, 25% of CO2, that is, these are greenhouse emission gases. Agriculture consumes around 70% of fresh water. One-third of energy has been consumed by agriculture and producing food. Also, one-third of food produced is wasted, and this is, as we see, both. We produce and we also waste. And also 60% of antibiotics which are used or produced globally, they are used for cattle, and it is also, it reaches also environment. So besides that, with these challenges and problems with climate, there are 2.2 billion of people obese people, so it is not enough movements, and it is wrong eating habits. And at the same time, we have 800 million of people starving, and the more we develop, the more this gap is. And we have COVID challenge, and we see that in some countries cannot pay for food, and they cannot produce themselves. And one of the topics, protein is missing in the world, so and it is we see that we need more proteins, so to labor use more land, more water, and we have a new project. So it's protein which is really needed, which is missing in the world. So here it is, we see the forecast that it plus 265 million tons of protein till year 2050. So our environment should be better. And right now in Latvia we grow around 4 million tons of grain products, and more than 70% we are exporting as raw materials so for processing in other countries, and we have not much of value added here. And now we have a project with this ASNS ingredient, which is yellow pea protein isolate production, or it is concentrate, so we are making such a factory. And the name, so ASNS, this means, from the English side, it would be smart nutrition solutions, so smart nutrition solutions, but if you read it the Latvian way, actually this is, as you know, it is a sprout which is growing, emerging from the soil, but it can go through asphalt or concrete, and from sprout you we see trees, and we see, so everything what is growing starts with a sprout. So this is in name, this is the beginning of something very stable, very big and worldwide known. So this is, so the project is to build such a factory for producing full cycle yellow pea protein isolate processing. And so this is really, this isolate is requested in different fruit processing sectors. So side products would be also starch and starch concentrate, so pea whole fiber, and would be meat substitute. So it is whole range of products with very high added value and with demand in the market. So it would be very good to, so actually very many issues solved regarding CO2 emissions, because peas as such is a very valuable plant for farmers. So it is for crop rotation and also peas, so and bees, beans, so they shouldn't be fertilized with nitrogen, and so they are very good actually as a plant, and you shouldn't use imported fertilizer. Also much of nitrate is left in the soil. The value of the project, it is 75 million euros, which will be invested in two tiers. First tier is 53.5 million euros, and when we complete this, then around 2022 we could start production, and in 2024 or 2025 could be the second stage of the factory, and then according to today's plans would be maximum capacity. Of course, we understand that the supply of this product could increase, and we also will grow more. And this is just initial stage which we are planning, and we think that we will expand later. So we would like to emphasize this is innovative plan, project. It is value added and really with high demand worldwide. And very, very many people are more eating healthy food, and this pea protein is the basis of such healthy food. So this is our production technology. It is very efficient. As I already said, it is innovative. We would receive 22.2 tons of pea protein isolate and starch, so everything is already tested. We have production processes and tests, and the technologies have been developed. Everything is tried and tested. We are sure about this process. We know what to expect, and what I would like to tell Latvia, climate in Latvia is very favorable for growing peas, and we know that peas love this soil, peas love this environment, and we can really be very successful with good yield of peas here. And so this is our task and goal of the project, for growing peas, so this is also very good for crop rotation when also in Europe and also in the world, and especially in Europe, there is this fight against climate changes, and if we reduce influence of agriculture on climate changes, when we introduce more peas and beans, so agriculturists would really be in front of this. So why don't we have so much of leguminosae right now? Because right now the market is quite limited. Mostly we sell these to India, and transportation costs are very high. India's demand is changing, and if peas are growing well in Australia, then we do not have such big demand. And so here, if we can grow them, we can process, we have stabilized prices, and it is already financial, economic interest for farmers to grow peas and to process them locally. This is really very, very important for us here. So to leave less footprint of agriculture here is a very important side effect. So just in short about production of this, of course you can read all this, but this is a food industry, would be healthy snacks, it would be meat analogues, sport proteins, it would be baby food, it would be protein drinks, alternatives for milk products, it would be starch concentrate, which is used for food and for food industry. And this would be for gluten-free food products, for bread, for also for sauces and soups. Also, it can part of peas can be fiber of peas is for important raw material for meat analogues, and fiber is one of the basic elements to get such a meat analogue that looks like meat and also has the same structure. And also non-food industry is requesting, it is for biopolymers and bioplastic industry and paper industry. So plastics, which is produced from oil, should be substituted by other raw materials, and starch is one of these products out of which we can produce polymers, not from fossil raw materials, but of course proteins and starch, that is also a basis for forage. And so we can go through all this, and we have here I have enlisted main users of our products. We are discussing and negotiating this. Some of these have expressed a wish to participate as partners. Some would like to be buyers of our products or cooperation partners. And so we will see what will be the final decision, but they are both local companies, and we do hope that those local companies, local processing companies, would also develop together with us, and also innovations in other sectors. And so with those volumes which we plan, it would be global factory, global size factory, it would be one of the largest in Eastern and Northern Europe, and so we are also negotiating this with global wood processing concerns, and we could be a very good partner in providing supply, raw materials for Latvian economy. It would be assistance in development of new sectors in food, both food and non-food sector. So we have bioeconomy cluster together with Jelgava City Council and Latvian University of Agriculture, and we do hope for new members in this cluster, and that will be a possibility for development of food tech companies, and Latvia could reach new standards, new levels, global levels. Of course, we cannot exceed Canada, which is several steps ahead of us, but Latvia could be the second hub for protein production, not only growing of peas, but also innovations, research, and development of new products. And one more goal of this project. So the whole Europe is dependent on Europe and America and Canada. So we could, with our product, we could find our segment in this market, and as such, climate and environmental issues, so we would reduce CO2 and nitrogen. It is less consumption of water, because peas require less water, and so this, through this project, we could also improve situation with all those climate issues and with climate problems which we see. And also there should be additional working places in the very factory, and also with regard to growing peas, there could be LATRAPS would be beneficiary, and also RAPS, but also other farmers who are performing activities here in Latvia. And we also do hope that science will be interested in this and will join us, will join this project, and then also it will be benefit for agricultural research and one more very important aspect regarding this, it will be organic farming, because to have organic products, we need plants that bind nitrogen, and so we need a market where to sell these. And here we see also really this organic farming part of all this, so we would offer place where to sell those products to farmers who grow organic peas. And of course, the consumers, consumer factor, this is one need. We have to protect our farmer, we have to meet demands of the consumers, and we do hope that we could improve quality of the global population. We could be as slim as Valdis here, for instance, and we do hope that we will achieve this stage, so we hope to start production at 2022, so it will be in Jelgava. We have already, together with Vox, we have territory, so 5.6 hectares, and we are very optimistic regarding this. And we do hope that we will be successful, and we will be proud, and so we will be really proud of that.